Now we are going to discuss the different graphs of the chapter motion. These graphs help us to calculate the speed, the distance covered by the body and the acceleration. So one by one we will discuss about these graphs. Now we can use the speed and velocity in the same term. Okay, ab aapko clear hai ki what is velocity and what is speed. So for convenience we can use speed as well as velocity here. So first of all we are going to discuss distance time graph. Distance time graph which gives us the speed of a body at a particular point. Now this is distance time graph. Yahan par hume x axis par time liya hai and distance will be taken on y axis. Jab hum velocity time graph lenge that time again time will be on x axis and velocity will be on y axis. Distance time graph actually give us the speed of the body. So when we speed find out with the help of graph, we draw this distance time graph that can be easily find out. As slope of distance time graph give us speed of our moving body. Now slope kya hota hai? And that is just a mass y axis upon x axis. That will give us the slope or gradient of a graph. So यहाँ भी डिस्टेंस टाइम ग्राफ का स्लोप हमें उस बॉडी की स्पीड के बारे में एट अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट वी कैन फाइंड आउट. ओके, सो स्पीड कैन बी फाइंड आउट विद द स्लोप और ग्रेडियंट ऑफ दिस ग्राफ. अब यहाँ पर ओ सी इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय अ बॉडी. ओके, एंड जो कि ओ बी टाइम में कवर की गई. सो वी विल राइट OC and OC upon OB to find out the speed. But as we know AB is also equal to OC, so we can write here AB upon OB. Okay, so this is the slope of this distance time graph. So this slope will give us the speed of a moving body which is moving at a uniform speed. Now I will make it more clear to you. Now if a body starting from point O and reaches at point A और हमें इस point पर उस moving body की speed find out करनी है, मतलब हम यहाँ पर speed को y axis whole upon whole x axis that we cannot take here, so we will take the coordinates here. So with the help of these coordinates we can easily find out the speed of a moving body at a particular point. सो यहाँ पर कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या हो जाएंगे, सपोज दिस इज टाइम टी वन एंड इज हियर द टाइम बी टी टू एंड हियर डिस्टेंस कवर्ड इज डी वन. ओके, एंड हियर डी टू. सो नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस कोऑर्डिनेट्स वी विल इजली फाइंड आउट स्पीड. हियर विल बिकम दैट इज डिस्टेंस अपॉन टाइम, है ना. तो अब डिस्टेंस यहाँ पर वी विल कितना डिस्टेंस इतने टाइम में कवर किया है दैट विल इजली फाइंड आउट बाय डी टू माइनस डी वन. सो डी टू माइनस डी वन अपॉन एक्सरसाइज दैट इज टी टू माइनस टी वन, टी टू माइनस टी वन. ओके, अब अगर हम वैल्यू रख देते हैं व्हाट वी विल गेट, डी टू दैट इज 60 माइनस डी वन दैट इज 0 upon T2 that is 30 and here T1 that is 0 will give us 60 upon 30 which is equal to 2 meter per second. So here the speed is 2 meter per second. If we want to calculate the speed of the same body but at point B, थोड़ा सा और आगे बढ़ देंगे, ठीक है. हमें यहाँ पर जानना है कि इस body की speed कितनी है. So same thing we will do. Now here this become T2 and this will become, क्योंकि हमें यहाँ से A से B तक जाने में हम find out कर रहे हैं, this will become T1. Okay, and here this will become T1 now and this will become T2. Now at point B the formula will be same, that is speed is equal to T2 minus T1 upon T2 minus T1, but now the values will be changed क्योंकि अब T2 ये है, T1 ये है, D2 ये है and D1 is this. So what we will write, D2 minus d1 upon t2 minus t1. Okay, what it will be here? 40 upon 20, again it is 2 meter per second. So we can see that both are the answer same. So what we learn from these two readings, this is also 2 meter per second at point A and speed is also 2 meter per second at point B. So what it is telling that the body is moving with uniform speed. Okay? So practice more for this graph. Take some data, practice more and it will be much easy for you to calculate the speed of a moving body at a particular point, the body which is moving with uniform speed.